When we throw a ball upward, it falls back due to gravity. Then how do satellites launched don't fall back and continue to orbit the Earth at a particular altitude? What is the principle behind, and how does the same principle operate a washing machine, separates our blood components, and prevents our cars from toppling? The answer for these questions, in fact, saved millions for India's space mission to Mars. Watch the video till the end to know how it happened. Centrifugal force is the apparent force felt by an object moving in a curved path that acts outwardly away from the center of rotation or the center of curvature. According to Newton's third law, for each action there is an equal and opposite reaction. The force that is necessary to neutralize centrifugal force and to keep an object moving in a curved path and is directed inward towards the center of rotation is called the centripetal force. In other words, one force is an action and another is a reaction. These forces are same in magnitude and opposite in direction and calculated by the formula F is equal to mv squared divided by r. Here m is the mass of the moving object, v is the moving velocity and r is the radius of the curvature. According to Newton's first law of motion, the object will remain in rest or motion unless otherwise acted upon by an external force. The Earth pulls the satellite downward due to its gravity. To keep the satellite from falling on Earth, we need an additional force to balance the effect of gravity. We can't provide the additional force using fuel throughout the life of the satellite. Instead, satellites carry small quantities of fuel only for maneuvering to change orbits or avoid collision with space debris. Then how does the balancing force is maintained throughout the life of the satellite? The answer lies with the rockets. When the rockets release satellites into their orbits, satellites pick up the initial momentum which balances the Earth's gravitational force. A satellite orbiting closer to the Earth requires more velocity to resist the stronger gravitational pull. Scientists calculate the initial detaching speeds according to the altitude of the orbit. Washing machines and cloth dryers are one of the classic examples of centrifugal force. The drums of domestic washing machines typically spin at the rate ranging from 500 to 1500 revolutions per minute. When these drums spin at the speed, the water molecules clinging to the cloth are thrown away due to centrifugal force. The thrown away particles pass through the perforated drum and get disposed via an outlet. The delicate fabrics may get damaged because of the same centrifugal force. Hence, it is important to choose washing modes with appropriate spinning speeds based on the fabric you are washing. Many of us donate blood to the needy. Most of the time, donated blood is not infused to the patients as such, because patients sometimes need particular components of the blood like plasma, platelets, or red blood cells. So it is necessary to segregate the components before infusing them to patients or storing them for future use. Components of blood vary in their density. When blood is subjected to centrifugal force, the components segregate and settle in distinct layers based on their densities. As plasma has the least density among all the components, it settles at the topmost layer. Plasma layer is immediately followed by the buffy coat consisting of white blood cells and platelets. The red blood cells with the highest density form the bottommost layer. Have you ever wondered why racing tracks and highways have elevated curves? Technically, this is called banking of curves. When vehicles turn at higher speeds along a curved path, centrifugal force may exceed the frictional force between the road and tires. This eventually leads to the toppling of vehicles. So curves are banked at specific angles corresponding to the speed of the passing vehicles. Banking of curves imparts enough centripetal force to the vehicles to withstand the effect of centrifugal force and keep them in circular motion. Now over to India's space mission to Mars. While the USA spent around $582 million for its Mars mission named MAVEN, ISRO spent just one-tenth of it by utilizing this basic concept in its Mars Orbiter mission. After its launch on 5th November 2013, India's Mars rocket made a series of seven apogee-raising orbital maneuvers around the Earth. After those successful maneuvers, Transmars injection was carried out on 30th November 2013. These orbital maneuvers can be compared to the action of a discus throw athlete. The athlete imparts maximum momentum to the discus by his revolving action before releasing it. Likewise, through every apogee maneuver, the rocket's momentum was increased. Momentum created using Earth's gravity reduced the need for heavier rockets and fuel demand. After a 298-day transit to Mars, finally the Indian satellite Mangalyaan was placed into Mars orbit on 24th September 2014. Thank you for watching this video. For more such science and engineering videos, subscribe to Black Story.